treaties that the church in her wisdom gives us every single year. Last week the temptation and today the transfiguration. They are given to us every single year. That means the church believes that the points made there are of primary importance. And every year I try to go a little deeper with this story. They go up on the mountain, they see they're in heaven. They're in heaven. A couple days after the Super Bowl, you notice I've said nothing about the Eagles winning the Super Bowl. I've kept it very quiet, you know me, quiet and shy. But one of the announcers who did not play football as his career asked one of the players, well, do you think you can repeat next year? Which, of course, is what everybody wants. Are we going to be here every year, every year, every year? And the player said back, he said, you understand what it takes to be here? We start in July at training camp. It's 100 degrees, and you almost kill yourself. Because if you don't make the team, you get cut. You lose a lot of money. You play 4 exhibition games. You play 16 regular season games. At the end of the year, you're playing in snow and cold. Your fingers are barely able to move. On Monday morning, you can't get out of bed. That's how beat up your body is. Then they have the playoffs. Then you have the Super Bowl. He said, do you realize what we do? Blood, sweat, and tears. We're not even thinking about next year. We just want to like go home and take like a month off. That's what football does to you. Blood, sweat, and tears. Do we want to be here again next year? Of course. But they're not even thinking about that. They're thinking about what a football player goes through. Now, they are well paid, yes. But you want to be a champion. You know what the price you pay is? That's what that reading is about today. They're up on the mountain, and they're in heaven. And they want to stay there. So would I. I hope my team wins every game, every year. I want to be on the top of the mountain. But Jesus says, do you realize what this involves? Are you ready to go through a Good Friday? Nobody gets to Easter Sunday without going through the suffering, the blood, sweat, and tears. There's the cross right there. Are you ready to go through that? Are you ready for that? And the answer was they weren't. They all failed, pretty much. They were not ready to go through the suffering to get to Easter Sunday. And the profound implication for us is to ask ourselves, are we? Do we understand that there is no resurrection without death? Our own Good Fridays. Yes, I speak from a unique position. I have buried your parents. I have buried your spouses. Sometimes I have buried your children. I, more than anybody, wants the sufferings you go through. I have my own, I want you to go through yours. I've buried so many. So many. But there's no way to heaven without death and suffering. Are we ready to accept that? There's no other way. And you might say, who's ready for that? Well, it's been happening, the death and the resurrection. It's been happening all your life. Maybe we didn't see it. I have experienced many deaths. There was the death of my youth, that it's gone. Being a young person is gone. I have to accept that. I have to let that go. I used to play this one hole, and I could reach it with a 5-iron. Now I'm 20, 25 yards short. And I thought about giving up the game. I'm a reasonably talented golfer. It's not fun anymore. My brother said, maybe we have to play other golf courses, because we can't reach the green anymore. And I had to let that course go. Now I play other courses, meant for older men. It's fun again. When I was young, I thought, well, I want to get the title on seniors. Fancy title. I want to get this parish over here. That's never going to happen. They are never going to name me a Monsignor. I got a big mouth. They don't name guys like me Monsignor. But I had to let that go and realize I got the best parish on earth right here. You can't get a seat at the 11 o'clock mass some days. Nobody can say that. We can. But I had to let that go. I had to let that die. See, that's a death I had to experience. And it's not just the old people. You see the young guy who wants this girl, 25-year-old, to go out with him so badly. He thinks she's the most beautiful thing on earth, and to him, she is. And that's never going to happen. There is no ache on earth worse than love that is not returned. And he carries a torch in his heart. Once he realizes, let her go, then he'll go and he'll find another beautiful girl. But he's gonna let that go. Let that die. And it's hard to do when you're young. Or he thinks he's gonna play football at Notre Dame. Very few kids play football at Notre Dame. But there are other colleges that might want him. But he's gotta let that go. And when he lets go, then he can let God. Only when he has that death can he have a resurrection. And that's the spiritual life. There's death, and only death leads to resurrection. If you don't have a good Lent, you'll have no Easter. Waste your time. Quit now. Save yourself the trouble, unless you're dying to yourself in some way, to something that's a sin. And only when you do that can you understand Good Friday. Good Friday, listen to all the things that happen on Good Friday. Jesus lets Pilate condemn him. He lets Judas betray him. He lets Peter deny him. He lets the soldiers scourge him. He lets the soldiers strip him. He lets the soldiers kneel him. And he lets the pallbearers, whoever they were, place him in the tomb. He let passion means be passive. He lets things happen to him so that God can take over. He was able to die perfectly so that he could then experience Easter perfectly. I struggle to do that, to suffer, but only then can I rise. Don't ask what you do for Lent. Ask what you let God do in you, for you, and through you. Lent is about letting go your own passion so that you can let God. Let us stand, my friends, we'll profess our faith in Almighty God.